The court presided over by Justice George Boedi granted the ex-party application filed by the NDC's parliamentary candidate for the Hohoi constituency, Professor Margaret Kweku, and five others. Lawyers for the applicants argued that preventing the people of the four traditional areas in the Hohoi area from taking part in the parliamentary election was a violation of their fundamental human rights. The lawyers therefore prayed the court to restrain the EC from gazetting the Hohoi parliamentary results whilst demanding action for the enforcement of their fundamental human rights. The application also sought to restrain the Electoral Commission from presenting John Peter Mew as the elected representative for the people of Hohoi, whereas seeking to prevent him from presenting himself to be sworn into office as a member of parliament for the area. However, Deputy General Secretary of the MPP, Nana Obibuanyi, says the move is just an attempt to frustrate the processes related to the elections and determination of John Peter Mew as the new MP for the Hohoi constituency.
They are joking. They are joking. They are joking. They can, as it were, just create an imaginary situation. Because, you see, as for Hohoi, I don't want to run any extensive commentary on that. But I tell you, at the material time there, judge granted the injunction, the EC had already done with the gazette. So lawyers would describe that as brutal foemen. Okay. Brutal foemen. So some of us are not worried at all. As a lawyer, I'm not a wee bit worried about what is happening in Hohoi at all. So I mean, let's relax. Okay. But you see, you should not run away from the fact that the MPP also will go to court. A good number of constituencies. I am telling you, because the legal committee has also been meeting. So let's relax. We will cross the bridge when we come to that.
So you are confident when you go to court, you might get some of the results attend, and then you might get a solid majority?
I am saying that let's not worry ourselves at all. We will cross the bridge when we come to that. But for now, the most important thing is we are looking at the entire picture of the party in the foreseeable future. That is what we need to look at.
Meanwhile, the Volta Regional Police Command says it has begun investigations into allegations of assault and torture leveled against some supporters of John Peter Mew. A court bailiff, Emmanuel Asiaka, is alleging that he was assaulted when he traveled to Hawaii to present court documents to Mr. Peter Mew. Here is the Volta Regional Police PRO, Sergeant Prince Dugwache.
Someone made a report to the police that he was attacked whilst he went to serve an injunction order on the Minister for Energy. And so we took the report, and then because he was injured, we issued him with the medical report form to attend hospital. He has since returned the medical report form to us. We are on our investigation. We haven't made any arrests yet, but we hope that with his assistance, we'll be able to get the suspect. Oh, we are really working, so justice to be served in the case, because nobody has the right to abuse the other when they are particularly executing a lawful order from the court. I mean, that is unacceptable.